Hey everyone, it's Tom Krause with another Rockstar Minute. We're going to talk about this and we're going to talk about this tweet that came up on my computer. I don't know if anyone else follows the Bank of Canada on Twitter because it's like the most exciting thing you can do. And earlier this week, they sent out this tweet that was just fascinating. I have to read it to you. It says, authorities must monitor hashtag fintech innovation and address risks, says FSB, which is the Financial Security Board, I believe. Group chaired by our senior deputy governor Wilkins. So let me read that one more time. Authorities must monitor fintech innovation and address risks, says FSB group chaired by our senior deputy governor Wilkins. So basically the Bank of Canada is concerned about these cryptocurrencies and this financial technology that's going on around the world. And this to me is a completely laughing matter for a couple of reasons. They are worried about the Canadian dollar. So instead of talking about the Canadian dollar and the value of the Canadian dollar, they're worried about things like Bitcoin. And I know there's like a lot of malware and different things going on in the news and people are getting paid ransoms in this Bitcoin and different cryptocurrencies and the whole bit. But let's think about this for a second. Our Bank of Canada is saying that this is a concern and we must address the risks. Why are they not paying more attention to our dollar? Let's face it, the only thing that gives this thing any value, in my opinion, and I know we can debate this all day long, but in my opinion, is that the government makes me pay taxes in this. That's really the only thing that gives this a lot of value. If I could pay my taxes in anything else, I could get paid in anything else and I really could pay my taxes in it. But because they require that I pay my taxes in these things, it gives us a lot of authority in the country because everybody, all of us, are getting paid in this currency. We pay our taxes in this currency and it gives this a lot of strength. That's kind of, in my opinion, the only thing that is giving this a lot of strength. The only other thing globally around this kind of currency situation from different big economies that give this value right now is that we all use the SWIFT system to move money around the world. So if different countries want to buy oil and pay for the oil, they use SWIFT. And you and I would use the same thing if we were going to wire money from Canada to, let's say, Europe or another country. When we wire money, we get those SWIFT codes and we send money around the world. And because all these countries, all these big economies are controlling that and we all use the same system, it does make it easy to move money around the world. But really, you know, that's to me just another tool for big economies to control or slap around other economies when they deny them access to the SWIFT system. And you see that and sanctions around the world and everything like that. But if you boil it down and really just look at the value of this thing, what's the difference between this and some kind of cryptocurrency other than our government collects taxes and asks us to pay it in this? So when I see a tweet that says, you know, that we must, the bank authorities must monitor this innovation and address the risk, it makes me laugh. I tweeted back, I've never tweeted back to the Bank of Canada or replied. I said, hey, can you monitor the historic value of our dollar while you're at it and address the risks to the middle class because of it? Thanks. And I said, thank you afterwards. And the reason for that is, let's think about it. I looked up the Hamilton average price of a Hamilton home in 1970. It's about $10,000 in Hamilton. The average salary back, according to Stats Canada in 1970, was about $5,000. So if it's about four or five times the your annual salary, you could buy a home. Now, if we look at that today, the average salary home price in Hamilton, according to the Hamilton Real Estate Board, is about $500,000. According to StatsCan, the average income in Canada is $36,000. So today, it takes about 14 or 15 times your salary to buy a home in Hamilton. Back in 1970, it only took like four or five times. So what's happening to the value of this thing? If we use Toronto's numbers, it takes about 30 times the average salary to buy a home. So what is happening to the value of this? Why are they worried about these Bitcoin things? And why don't we have all these kind of wonderful reports focusing on the value of this and what's happening to the middle class? Because the value of this is going down year over year and no one seems to be paying too much attention to it. Definitely not of our Bank of Canada on the Twitter account anyway. So hopefully that gives you something to think about. We still love the country. We're proud to be Canadian. It's the 150th birthday. Hopefully everybody enjoys this upcoming long weekend. Until next time, your life, your terms. Good?
Yes.
We're live?
Yeah.
We're live this time.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
Hey everyone, we're going to talk about money and this tweet that came up on my computer. I don't know if anyone else followed. Are we live?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I did, for some reason, the way you were looking.
No, because I think you stand so like a...
Oh, so where should I go?
I think, yeah, that's perfect.
Good?
Yeah.
Okay. We're good?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.